Well, hello there. We're finally back. Here we are on Sunday night, October 13th, 2019 at 7:30 p.m. up here in northeastern Ohio. And I've been out for the last couple days trying to get footage, but I've been having one issue after another. Electronic glitches, technical ones, old lady glitches, the whole gambit. And though we're going to try again for a third night in a row. So at the moment I have two cameras running. The Canon 80D is trying to get video footage. I don't know how well that's going to come out. I no longer have the 90D. I had to send it back, which really bummed me out. It had a stuck red pixel in the 4K video portion, and it just drove me nuts. So, within that 30-day window, I had to send it back, and it just, I love that camera, man. But I just could not accept that. Not for a brand new camera, sorry. And I did want a replacement, but I don't think that part of the order went through, so we'll just have to wait and make sure all the money gets put back in, refunded, and go from there. So again, like I said, the 80D is running a wide field of view, but it doesn't have very good low light, so I don't know how well that's going to come out over there. Probably not well. I had the ISO on 6400. I moved it up to 8000. It's probably going to make it way worse. But anyway, now let's get over to the Nikon. Now tonight we have three of Jupiter's moons should be showing. Io should be in front of the planet, so I don't know if we'll be able to see a shadow of it or not once we change the exposure to try to get the bands and detail the planet in, so we'll give that a go here. Now tonight there should be the great red spot showing in our general direction. Oh boy, it's not coming in good. I tried to get the focus in before we even started, but just not happy with that. Yeah, I can't even make out the details here. Okay, so if I include the clip here, if it comes out on the other camera, we can see the landscape and where the planets are in the sky, and we can see how low Jupiter is as it heads towards that tree. And I was really hoping it would come in better because we have that great red spot tonight and Io up above it. Anyway, I think that's going to be it for poor Jupe. Alright, let's do this and try to head over to Saturn. Now tonight we have a full moon rising. I don't see it yet, but it should be up 6 degrees above the horizon, but I don't see anything over there in the east yet. But then I have houses and trees in the way. Okay, so Jupiter's 18 degrees up above the horizon and Saturn is 26, so that's where we're going to try to go to. There we go. Mess around here and try to get Jupiter, not Jupiter, but Saturn in. Alrighty. So I think we have clips of everything. The moons of Jupiter, Jupiter itself, which I don't think is going to come out very well. Now Saturn. Oh, and I do see the moon peeking in between those tree branches over in the east. And I'm going to have to do a complete realignment because I'm going to have to move us for that. But it is so cool to be able to get the planets here with the Nikon P1000 with any camera that has a telephoto lens on it. It can be hard to center them and get it focused, and it's a challenge. And I know it's not telescope quality, but still cool what we can capture. And that should be a good look here at our ring partner. Our banded one and ringed one. Oh, and for those that are interested, I believe it's next week when we should have a good show of meteor showers over in the southern sky when Orion is up, Orion and Sirius. We'll be going through the debris trail of Halley's Comet. You know what's funny about that? I grew up probably for the first 50 some years of my life calling it Halley's Comet. I mean, that's all we ever knew it as. And I don't know, it could have been about 15 years ago when I heard someone call it Halley's Comet. And I was like, what? What are they talking about? It's Halley's Comet. Anyway. It'll be in the early morning sky. Probably between, I don't know, 2 a.m. and 5 a.m. might be a good time to see it next week. So if you look up towards the constellation of Orion, you might be able to see some meteors shooting by. Okay. All right, we have to go relocate, so. All right. One camera down, or up, whatever. Get this other one set up. There we go. Alrighty, we're all set up here. I think we have the tracking situated on our full moon rising in northeastern Ohio. It's up about 8 degrees above the horizon, and it's over in the east, heading towards the southeast, while Jupiter and Saturn were over in the south-southwest. So we can see how watery it is because it's so low in the sky. Now I'm surprised there's not a whole bunch of bats and birds flying across it. It'd be so cool to see a flock of geese in a V formation. We got one once before. What was it, a couple months ago? I forget when it was. I suppose I could try to go in, but there's really no sense in it because you can't see any details of the craters, and you can't see the depth of them, or it's more of a dull view. I don't know. I don't know what you'd call it. Now, I would like to try to get it in a bit better. This is going to be a shaky process, though. All right, there we go. I think we have a better focus now. It was so weird those few nights where We couldn't focus at all on it. It was driving me nuts. I didn't know if there was something wrong with my camera or what, because we didn't have any clouds in the sky. And it was up higher than I think Saturn was at the time, so it probably would have been up about 26, 28, 30 degrees above the horizon. So, yeah, I don't know what was going on with it back then. Ah, come on, this isn't fair. I want some flybys tonight, you guys. Boy, that sounds like a high flyer up there, doesn't it? I can see on the one camera it's getting close to the tree branches. But this other camera that has the full look, it's over a couple feet away, so from the other, so it has a bit better angle. Anyway, it's nice to get out here now before it gets too cold. Last night it got down to 33 degrees here. And I was out taking footage, but oh man. That was a technical nightmare last night, so. And just for reference, I was having so much trouble with the Orion SynScan handset. And that was one of the issues of last night, just one of them though. So tonight I am trying the phone app, and it's working okay, but it's going to be hard to use something like this in the winter time when you have gloves on, and I like the tactile feel of the buttons. But now that's my second handset, and I'm just not happy with the quality. Well, I guess nobody is gonna do a flyby tonight. Figures, I got it in pretty good. And boy, I do have a lot of light pollution around here. Well, it doesn't help with a full moon, but, and I can't see any stars up there. I know the camera picks up so much more, but it has better eyes than I do. Now tonight there is a large halo ring around the moon. It's very, very pretty. And it's quite round too. Unlike the oval one we had last week. Well, I'm going to call it a bus for a flyby night. That's disappointing, guys. Come on. Well, maybe something did fly by while I was looking around. We just have a lot of footage to go through. Anyway, that should do it on this Sunday evening up here in northeastern Ohio. So I'm going to wave goodbye to you and hope you have a great start to your new week, and that y'all stay safe and warm too, or cool if you need to be, wherever you are in the world. Anyway, waving goodbye from up here. It's now 8:04 p.m. Bye now.